Everyone, today I will discuss about creating a AEM project using Maven Archetype. I will be using Maven Archetype 23, which is the latest right now. Latest demo site Wink is also based on Maven Archetype 23. So in this tutorial, I will be discussing like how you can create a AEM project using that command, and I also discussing some important parameters of that command. Apart from this, I will also discuss like how you can add core component and ACS commons in your project as a dependency, and also embed both so that they might be also, you know, deploy with your project. And finally, I will be discussing like how you can add any third-party bundle as a dependency in your project and also embed that so that that third-party dependency is also deployed to AEM with your project. So let's start. And it's used with parameters to create your AEM projects. These parameters define to give custom inputs to this ambient command. So I'll be discussing few important parameters which is being used to create your AEM projects. There are few other parameters as well, but I did not mention it because they'll take their default value itself. So let's discuss these parameters one by one. First two are internally used and will not change any value. Will keep those values as it is. Archetype version, you can define your archetype which is being used to create your AEM projects. AEM version, you can define here either your AEM version or cloud. If you are using your AEM is running over cloud, then you can mention here cloud. If you are mentioning here cloud, then you have to mention your SDK version as well, latest SDK version. App title, basically this is the application title and also used for title for your website, and also component group names, this is also used for the component groups. App ID, basically this is the technical name and can also be used for your configurations, client libraries and the folder names. So this is the parent folder name under apps, and also this is the name of your website. Let's move on. Group ID, this is the base Maven group ID and also used for Java source packages. Front end module, basically it include your webpack front end build module that generate your client libraries. Like you can mention here either none or general if you are using normal sites. If you are using single page application, then you can use either Angular or React as per your use, whatever you are using. Include dispatcher configurations. This configuration, this parameter is used to include your dispatcher configuration as per your dispatcher 2.0 specifications. So you must be wondering why Adobe include this configuration here. So as you must be aware, like we are using Cloud Manager now to deploy our code, and Cloud Manager does not allow your code base to deploy if you do not have your dispatcher configuration. So you should have your dispatcher configuration as a module in your code base. So by default it's a yes. If you don't give this parameter, your AEM project will have your dispatcher configuration. I mentioned here in no because we'll discuss, you know, these dispatcher configuration in another video. Language and country, basically this is the language and country code to create your content structure. Single country, okay. Basically this include a language master content structure, so you can keep either yes or no here, why or no. Include examples, so if you want to include your component library example site, like if you want some content which contain your components examples, so then you should say yes here. So let's run this command. So one more thing, before running this command, you should make sure like whenever you copy paste this command to your terminal or your command prompt, so you should have all the parameters in a single line. So let's execute this. Open command prompt or terminal on a folder where you want to create a project. Let's open terminal. Run that command what I explained you. For just make this process faster, I have already keeping the those commands in a text file, so let me copy from there. and run this command. Okay, I see the build success. So the project has been created under that folder. So let's see that project. Go to demo where I created this project. See, AEM Geeks project has been created. You see there are different modules. So latest archetype defined different module because it's a multi-module project. So what exactly latest archetype does? Include your packages and your bundles in a single package, and that package is deployed to your AEM. So all your core bundles and your packages will club together in a single package under apps, and that package you can deploy to your AEM. So let's build it. Go to your AEM and see if I'm able to build it. Let's ambient clean install. So build successful. Let's see. So if you see, there is a package created under all. So this package, AEM all, this package contained your apps package as well as your bundles, whatever created in your core. So now simply you can install this bundle and this package, and this package would be enough. It will contain all your packages and bundles. Now let's add core component to your project. Go to parent form. Project parent form. Go to dependencies. If you go to dependencies, you'll find the core components. You see the core components has been already added by default while you create project. So let's update version of core components. Go to properties. Where the version defined, properties, and the version, core component version. You see the current version is 2.8 and it's working fine as we have already built it. So let's update current version from 2.8 to 2.9, save it and try to build it. Let's go ambient clean install. So this is the problem. You see the example package is not available for 2.9. So to resolve this issue, rather than adding those modules separately, we can add a single module. Let's check. Go to the dependencies again. If you see here, they added three different modules, each module for one for content, one for config, and one for example. So rather than adding these three modules separately, we can add a single module all, which contain all the required modules. So let's do it. I have already keeping that code in one of the files, so let me copy. So we'll replace all three modules with all module. You can see here, this is all module. Go to parent form and replace these three modules, these three dependencies, module dependencies. Update, say you need to replace these three dependencies in all module as well, and as well as if we are using in other module. So go to all, go to parent. You need to check where these three modules being used as a dependency. Go to this embedded section and see three embedded sections are for one for each module. So you need to remove these, and we'll use this all module as a sub package, not embedded. I'll let you know what is the difference between embedded and sub package. So let's add a sub package. Go to demo. I am already keeping this. you just need to paste this thing there, which instruct that like you need to add this sub package to my project. Copy it all, just add this under sub package section, save and go to the dependencies in same file. These dependencies are not being used now because we have already removed these three. Add a dependency for all, go here, I have already have it, just copy and paste there. All, add as a dependency here for all, right? We'll keep core as it is wherever we are using core. So we did not, if you see in parent pom, we did not touch core, we only replace the content packages. Okay, all, and we need to check if anywhere else we are using these three dependencies, so we need to remove those as well. So go to UI apps, check pom. Okay, in these pom, okay, we are using these two as a dependency, so let's remove these two dependencies as we are not using, we are using all. Remove it. And remove the dependencies if we are using anywhere else as well. These two, just remove it. As we have already removed, just try to build. Now, oh, look like we did not remove from all, we did not save all. Oh, it's not save actually. Let's save it. Let's save it and now build it. It's a build and successful. So in that way, now if you want to update your version, core components version, you can simply go to the parent pom, go to the properties, and you just need to update this version, and that's it, that's enough. Now let's add ACS Commons to your project. As we added core components, go to parent pom. Add dependency, inside dependencies, add dependency for ACS Commons. I have already keeping that dependencies with me. So add these two dependencies in parent pom. Add it. You see, so I'm using a variable for version. So we can define this version in properties. Go to properties and we can add one more entry for ACS Commons. So I'm keeping with me this version. So I'm using 4.7.2, later on we can update to any version. And as we added core component submodule, we need to add this ACS Commons submodule in all module package. So go to the all, open pom, see in sub packages, as we added this core component all, we can add one more sub package for ACS Commons. Go to this site, I have already keeping it. So add this sub package in all pom, all module pom, save it, add dependency as well as we added for this. you can get more information about how to add your core components in your ACS Commons in your project. I'll add the links or the URL in description. You can refer those URLs. Save it. One more thing, when once you build it, you can get some index error, because this ACS Common includes some indexes. So you need to allow indexes to deploy. By default, it's a false. So you need to add one more allow index entry. So you go to this file vault packaging plugin. Under this, you need to add this. I have already added it right now. Index allow index definition true. By default, it's not there. You have to add this as well. Otherwise, you'll get some error. So we have added that. Now try to build. Yeah, it's a successful. So now you can test this by deploying this package to your AEM. You can deploy via the configuration manager, or you can run one command. So to check those command, go to your project, go to your readme.md file, open it. See, there is a few commands are written there. So how you can deploy? You should find subcommand. See, if you want to build and deploy your complete project, you can run this command. It's up to you. You can directly go to the project your package manager and deploy from here. So if you directly want to deploy, go to your package manager, upload, go to demo this and all. You need to deploy only this package, that's it, all package, and all your packages and bundles will be deployed to your AEM instance. So I will not follow this, just cancel it and use this command to deploy your package to your AEM. Make sure your AEM should be running on 4502, otherwise you have to update your port number in properties in parent POM. So there's multiple commands available. This command is used to deploy your package to your author instance. Let's run it. It will build and deploy. Success. Let's see your instance. Just refresh it. Okay, you see your package is deployed. Your all is deployed with all package. You see your ACS common packages has been all deployed. This content apps and this content, and this AC, core components are also deployed. 2.9 version, which we defined 2.9 version for core components and 4.7.2 for ACS Commons. So in that way, you don't need to deploy these core component ACS Commons separately. Those will be clubbed together in your project code base. One more scenario, you need to deploy something on Amazon S3 bucket. For that, you need Amazon SDK. So to resolve that dependency, you include that dependency in your parent POM as well as your core module. So your code will build successfully. So but once you deploy that your code base to your AEM, your code will not work there, because that Amazon S3K dependency or bundle will not available in AEM. So to resolve that kind of issues, apart from adding Amazon S3K as a dependency, you also embed that bundle to your code base so that once your code is deployed to your AEM, that dependency will also deploy with your code and that will be available at AEM. So let's take a look how we can add that. Again, go to the parent form. How to add dependency, you know that. So go to the parent form, dependencies, add one more dependency for Amazon S3K. Add a dependency for Amazon S3K in parent form. Right, and you need to add this dependency to the core module as well, or in wherever which module you are using. So that will resolve your problem. But to embed this bundle or dependency in your code to deploy in your AEM, go to all form, and embed that jar or bundle. You see, now we did not add a sub package. So if you have any jar bundle, you mean to say bundle, you need to embed that. And for package, you need to either you can embed or add as a sub package. But if you are embedding it, you need to define where you want to install that. So if you give some other path, that will install at other path, but in sub package, these packages will be installed in your etc packages. So let's make an entry for Amazon SDK. Here I'm embedding this in all. I embedded, and see, I gave the path of apps AM Geeks and install, where I have my core also installed. And you need to add a dependency as well. Here we need to make a dependency. Add dependency for SDK. Save it and run that same command again. This command will build and deploy. Now there should be a jar installed under AEM, under apps / AEM Geek / install. Successfully deployed. Let's check. Let's refresh it. Go to AM Geeks, install. See, this aws-java-sdk-s3 install. So this is the way you can install. Okay. Please let me know if you have any questions or your concern. Please do comment if in case you have any question. Thank you very much.